आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव।
आजादी का सफर विद AIR न्यूज, बर्थ ऑफ अ नेशन। India's glorious freedom struggle is one of the greatest struggles the modern world has ever witnessed. AIR News brings you a glimpse of the struggle every day.
This Constituent Assembly declares its firm and solemn resolve.
The Objectives Resolution 1946 was introduced by Jawaharlal Nehru on 13th of December 1946.
Proclaim India as an independent sovereign republic and to draw up for her future governance a constitution.
This resolution was the reflection of aspirations of makers of the constitution and was later framed as the preamble of the Indian constitution. The assembly extensively debated the resolution between 16th and 19th of December. The resolution was again taken up for discussion on the 21st of January 1947. During these deliberations, the Assembly discussed various aspects of the Objectives Resolution and the political context that surrounded it, including the absence of princely states, federalism, minority rights and socio-economic rights.
Finally, on the 22nd of January 1947, after due deliberations, discussions and responses to various debates, the President of the Assembly, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, signalled to the members that the time had come to vote on the resolution. He read out the resolution, first in English, then in Hindi. Shri Mohanlal Saxena read out the Urdu translation. Members of the Assembly then voted in favour of the resolution and adopted it with all members standing.
The purpose of the resolution was to imagine a future direction of the Republic of India. The constitution was made by a few people, but it was the constitution of every Indian.
We, the people of India.
The very first sentence of the preamble, "We, the people of India," tells a story about the efforts of the makers of the constitution to capture the aspirations of all Indians. And this story, which was started by this resolution, later became the world-famous preamble of the Constitution of India.
Having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic.
Today we also remember noted Gandhian, freedom fighter and former bureaucrat Lakshmi Chand Jain, who was born on 13th of December 1925 in Rajasthan. While in his youth, Lakshmi Chand took part in the Quit India movement during 1942.
Later, in 1947, he was put in charge of the Kingsway camp in North Delhi, which was a shelter for displaced persons. He helped introduce cooperative societies for farming and cottage industries into rehabilitation camps.
After independence of India, he joined the bureaucracy and served as a member of the Planning Commission, as Indian High Commissioner to South Africa, as a member of the World Commission on Dams, and as Secretary of the Indian Cooperative Union and the All India Handicrafts Board. Jain was one of the earliest cooperative leaders in the country and helped Kamala Devi Chattopadhyay organize the Indian Cooperative Union. For his selfless commitment to attack India's poverty at the grassroots levels, Lakshmi Chand Jain was awarded the Magsaysay Award in 1988. In 2011, he was chosen posthumously for Padma Vibhushan by the Government of India, but the family declined to accept the award since he had been against the concept of state honours.
He died on the 14th of November 2010 in New Delhi. We salute this great Indian and his love for the motherland.
That brings us to the end of this episode of Azadi Ka Safar with AIR News. See you in the next episode tomorrow.